Welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on color sensing. This video will introduce and cover the basics of how colors are defined. The Introduction to Color Sensors chapter in this video series covered how colors are created and seen by the human eye. The spectrum of visible light ranges from 380 nanometers to 750 nanometers. Within that range, the corresponding wavelength of each visible color can be seen here. This video will discuss how the wavelengths of the visible spectrum can be combined to make other colors, and how this process has been standardized. Being able to accurately reproduce colors that are consistent across different manufacturers is an important part of display technology. Most modern displays mix together primary colors to create a wide range of other colors. Depending on the type of display technology, these primary color sources can be produced through emitters or special color filters. Colors can be produced on the display by adding various amounts of these primary sources. However, it's important to fully understand how people will perceive the results before these color mixtures can be produced. In a push to understand color perception in humans, there were two independent experiments performed by scientists W.D. Wright and J. Guild in the 1920s. In these experiments, observers were asked to adjust a series of primary light sources until the resulting color matched a reference light. The primary colors were monochromatic light sources, meaning that they are created from a single wavelength. The three primary light sources were on one side of a divided box, with the reference light on the other side. Participants were able to view the lights through a 2-degree field of view. This angle was to ensure that the light illuminated a part of the eye with high cone density, which would allow for better color perception. Each participant in the experiment was instructed to control the aperture angle of the red, blue, and green lights until the result matched the reference light. This process was then repeated with reference lights across the visible spectrum. If the amount of each source light is increased or decreased, but the ratio of the three stays the same, the resulting color will stay the same, but it will vary in brightness. Similarly, white light is created with equal amounts of the three primary lights. There were certain cases where the reference light could not be recreated with the three primary light sources. In order to solve this, a second primary light source was added to the reference side. This added light could then be adjusted along with the lights on the other side of the partition until a color match was made. For example, to create a bright green color, red light is needed on the opposite side of the partition to counteract the blue and green primaries. Since this experiment represents mixing together different ratios of primary colors, this opposite light source can be considered as a subtraction. As the wavelength of the reference light is swept across the visible spectrum, functions can be created for each of the red, green, and blue primaries, and the primary sources that were added to the reference side are represented as negative values. Functions for each of the three primary light sources were characterized as the reference light was swept across wavelengths of visible light. These functions illustrate the specific amounts of red, green, and blue light that are required to create light at a certain wavelength along the x-axis. The three functions are scaled so that each primary color is equally bright at each wavelength. The International Commission on Illumination, or CIE, standardized the RGB color matching functions in 1931, laying the foundation for the creation of color spaces. After the CIE established the RGB color matching functions, they were transformed to remove the negative values and ensure that the area under each curve is equal. Capital X, Y, and Z are the tri-stimulus values and can be obtained by computing the integral of the matching function for a given spectrum. Each tri-stimulus value can be represented as a proportion of the sum of all three, which must be equal to 1. Since X plus Y plus Z is equal to 1, the value of Z can be expressed in terms of X and Y. Now a projection in the XY plane can be created that does not require a three-dimensional plot. This projection shows the monochromatic wavelengths plotted in a coordinate system that is independent of light intensity. Monochromatic refers to light that is only made up of a single wavelength, and this curve is known as the spectral locus. The values on the spectral locus are the responses of the human eye across visible wavelengths, with the y-axis plotting relative luminance. Combining different points on the spectral locus creates other non-monochromatic colors that can be perceived by the human eye. The projection of all these colors is known as a color space. Color spaces create a way to group wavelengths and intensities based on how the human eye perceives them, allowing for standardized and reproducible colors across technology and manufacturers. The goal of a color space is to be able to numerically specify each color so that it can be accurately reproduced in various applications. The wavelengths on the spectral locus are known as monochromatic, referring to light that is only made up of a single wavelength. The color space represents how these wavelengths can be combined to create the colors that are seen inside of the color space. For example, depending on the amount of each of these selected monochromatic wavelengths, all of the colors within this triangle can be reproduced. Each color has a specific X and Y coordinate. However, TV monitors and other displays cannot emit a purely monochromatic color. What happens to the color space when the source wavelengths are not monochromatic? The resulting color set is much smaller and may look something like this, with the outside points of the triangle corresponding to the wavelengths emitted by the display's LEDs. This is known as a color gamut, a subset of colors that results from mixing the colors at the corners. Picking two points in the color space will create a line, with all of the colors along the line being made up of different amounts of the two endpoint colors. Earlier in this video, it was mentioned that equal combinations of colors within the visible spectrum will create white light. Based on the amounts of each wavelength, the appearance of the white light will change to be cooler or warmer. This is known as color temperature and is measured in Kelvin. White lights that are made up of more yellow and orange wavelengths are warmer, with color temperatures around 2700 Kelvin. Cool whites have more blue wavelengths and are usually 5000 Kelvin or more. Having a standard way to classify color temperature is important for many applications and ensures stable lighting conditions regardless of manufacturer. Color temperature is very useful for applications such as photography, lighting, and film. Any situation where the light will need to be adjusted or a camera will need to be calibrated based on surroundings has a need for accurate color temperature information. Color temperature can be represented within a color space on what is called the Planckian locus. A Planckian radiator is an ideal object that absorbs all light without reflecting anything. The spectrum of Planckian radiation can be seen here as temperature increases. The color of a Planckian radiator that matches a given light source most closely is known as that source's correlated color temperature, or CCT. The temperature dependence of Planckian radiation can be seen on the curve of the Planckian locus. The figure shown here is a projection of the CIE 1960 color space. The perpendicular lines are called isothermal lines, and they represent the color temperatures that are equal to each point on the locus. For each point in the color space, there is a corresponding color temperature determined by the isothermal line that is closest to the given coordinates. This is because real-life light sources will not have CCT values that lie directly on the Planckian locus, and an approximation must be made. The Wright Guild experiments explored the way humans see color and intensity, which formed the foundation that color spaces and other mathematical representations were built upon. Further differentiations of color temperature can be extracted from the emission spectrum of Planckian radiators, leading to increased standardization of light CCT in addition to color. For information on choosing the right kind of color sensor, please refer to the Choosing a Color Sensor for Your Application video in this series. To find more light sensor resources, please visit the link shown. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Please try the following quiz. A target color is created with various amounts of red, green, and blue light. What happens to the target color when the intensity of each primary is increased by the same amount? D. In RGB color matching, if all three primaries are increased by equal amounts, the resulting target color will stay the same but become brighter. What color will be created with equal intensities of 700 nanometer, 546 nanometer, and 436 nanometer wavelengths? C. White light is created with equal intensities of all different wavelengths.